What's going on, guys? It's Lego24 here with First Brick Production with another fantastic product! No, I'm kidding. Anyway, so, I'm here with, Megave.
Hello.
And FES, I don't know if you guys know, I have a Minecraft community called FE Server. Well, we've been working on a custom map slash custom game slash whatever you fuck want to call it. And it's 100% vanilla. We're on the newest snapshot, so once it actually becomes in the newest Minecraft, it'll be 100% vanilla, no mods, no plugins. And this man over here, this amazing man, invented a shop system that has in-game currency, as you can see in the captures on the side. That's no mods. This is all part of vanilla Minecraft. And it uses a shop system that uses command blocks and all the whole shebang where you could buy stuff and buy enchantments and such and such. So, Avery, do you want to explain a little bit?
Yeah, sure. Essentially what this is the first multiplayer compatible, completely reusable scoreboard integrated shop system in Minecraft. First of its kind, I invented for the project I'm currently working on with the support of James. It's part of a whole map system, and basically, every time you get a point, it goes into your score on the right side of your screen, as you can probably see. And once you get enough points, you can purchase things by going up to these buttons and pressing the buttons. Press the button, gives you the item.
Okay, do you want to tell me the command so that, do you want to demonstrate the command, I guess you could say, to give us captures so I can actually demonstrate buying stuff?
Sure, that would be scoreboard players add.
And watch the right side, guys.
Scoreboard players add Lego Kid. Let's see, Lego Kid 184. And because the score is called captures, I have to type in captures. It's case sensitive. Captures. And then add however many captures. So I'm going to give him 30.
As you can see, now I'm on 30. Now, if you're wondering what the different colors are, that's teams, which I'm not going to get too much into it. I'm not going to give too much away on the map. It's a work in progress map, but... And we might... Are we going to make it public, Avery? I don't know.
Yeah, we're going to make it public. Definitely going to make it public.
Are we going to give the downloads out and stuff like that?
That's a very good question. It all depends on after tests if it's very multiplayer compatible or if it's somewhat multiplayer compatible, because I'm currently having a little bit of trouble with multiplayer, but it will eventually be capable.
Yeah, otherwise it kind of wouldn't be successful because it's a multiplayer game. But anyway,
it works with a few people, 3 or 4 people, but if you're
you're talking about like 20s and 30s and stuff like that.
It will still work with a lot of people, but it gets a little slow.
And remember, guys, this is not using any mods, so it's 100% redstone command blocks. And I'll show you a little bit of the redstone after, and this is Nate. And as you can see, the kills are above his head, everyone's head. He's enjoying it, Nate. Nate? You can talk, you know, on Skype. It's okay.
So if you want to come outside and see...
Well, I want to actually buy stuff, so, okay. So
sure.
First off, I want to get my booties. I got me a pair of booties.
You got to get somewhat close to it. That's another thing I did. So that way it doesn't give it to somebody halfway across the world.
Yeah. And let's see. This will be take you back to the spawn lobby. And let's see. I want feather falling on my boots. And as you can see, feather falling, IV. Let's get some knockback. Some, let's see. Is fire aspect on this? Yep. And sharpness. Now, one thing that is slightly annoying, which I don't think it's possible, correct me if I'm wrong, Avery, but say if I have a pair of boots and I want to get knockback on them, as knockback cannot be put on boots, so it takes away the captures without giving you the actual knockback on the boots. So like you can see here, it took away my points and I didn't actually get it.
That falls into the realm of modding. There's really nothing in vanilla Minecraft I could possibly do to prevent you from losing the points if it doesn't work.
Correct.
However, if you have something such as too many items, it's possible to mod in the necessitating enchantment.
Correct. But I mean, for multiplayer aspects, yeah, that would kind of be a downfall, but. Anyway, we could just put signs. Anyway, so do you want to show us the actual shop system?
Sure.
Right here.
I'll start with the block here. I did these one's 2 blocks wide. However, as you can see over here, it's perfectly capable of being 1 block wide. Okay. And it's completely reusable. Every time you hit the button, it activates this first command block, which, did you click on it?
Yeah, I'm looking in it.
The command is give at P, and then it has left paren score underscore captures, once again, case sensitive, underscore minimum. And then what you're going to want to do is set how many captures they have to have in order for you to give it to the item. Now, it's very important you do min equals 2, because that will say, because that will prevent people from having 0 captures from going into negative points if they purchase something that's more than how many points they have. And then what I did here is I said range equals 5, because I was having a glitch before where if you did it and you didn't have enough points, it would give it to the closest person who did have enough points. So it's very important you set a range in order to prevent it from going to a completely random person. Next, you're going to want to do you're going to want to put in the item number, the ID. Here's a potion. This is, I believe, a splash potion of harming, and the potion base ID is 373. Then you want to say 1, and then you want to do the damage value. In this case, it's 16,396, as is most potions. Basically, what this command does is it only gives you the potion if you have enough points. Now, if you come down here, there's another command block hidden way down here. The base part of this command is scoreboard players remove, which basically says it takes away so many points. Then at P, score captures min. This is the same part as the other one, actually. It just says that it will only take away points if you have, at a minimum, so many points. And then once again, I set a range so it doesn't give somebody else the item or take away their points. Then what you're going to want to do is capitalized, do capture, or whatever the objective is. In other words, whatever you call the score system, you're going to want to do that capitalized and how many points you want to take away or add. And that's very important, because if you don't have the second command block, people can buy an infinite amount of items if they have that many points and they don't lose any. Now, the key here is you're going to want to have at least a 1 tick delay between the top one and the bottom one, or else you could end up losing the points before you get the item, and that would prevent you from getting the item in the first place. Okay. This soul system is incredibly compact. It can actually be even more compact than what I have here, but I didn't bother here because I had a lot of space.
And now this is the bigger version, I would assume.
This is my test version, this big one over here. This is the test version, but these are the final refined form. If you actually come inside this little nook here, you can see the smallest version of it.
Oh wow.
Yeah, this one's actually 1x3, or 2x3, which is pretty small. So this is the, as far as I'm aware of, the first multiplayer compatible, completely reusable, scoreboard integrated shop system.
And 100% vanilla.
In pure vanilla. Now, of course, this can be achieved through modding or through plugins. However, nothing like this has been done before vanilla.
Yeah, and the whole point of it is, say, since Minecraft has its own alien feature now, say you just start up, get up on Hamachi. I think you can do this with Hamachi, correct? I don't know if this is correct.
But I believe so.
You can just pretty much start this up in single player and just play it with your friends. It's nothing. And just click open the multiplayer on like the network, and there you go. And you can just play this map with all your friends without, and no one else will need the mods, nor will there have to be plugins. So, and oh, I shouldn't have gone in there. And so yeah, it's 100% vanilla. It's the best part about it is you don't need mods. And say if you don't know how to make a bucket server, then this is easy for you. And really, I don't think there's even any plugins out there that does all this. Now, this is a custom map too, so custom map-ish multiplayer game, and this is all the wiring that he's done all by himself, pretty much, except for
this
some
is actually. Yeah, sorry. This is actually only a sixth of the wiring that's exposed. There is over 20 kilometers of redstone so far, and it's about 2/7 of the way through. So, if that just gives you an idea. I had to invent a couple more circuits, which I may do videos on my own channel on, of some of the new circuits I had to invent for this, as well as an interesting little randomizer, which I found on the internet, which I can't remember who built this, but it's incredible. Regardless, thank you for taking the time to check out my shop system. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments and ask me about how it works.
And I will post his
more than happy to answer.
I will post his channel in the description, so if you want to private message him, is that okay with them, if they message you?
Of course! I love messages!
And is there anything else you want to show in this video that's really amazing about this map? Or anything that should be shown, I should say?
Well, we can show off the spawn room. Just show how that works.
Okay, yeah, we can do that. And we don't want to give away too much, though, because, you know, like I said, custom
work in
progress. Yeah, work in progress, and we don't want to, and all the buildings, so don't be like, oh wow, that's a really crappy building. Yeah, this is just, we're mainly working on the redstone right now. I know it's blocky and boxy, but we're mainly just working on the redstone. How'd you get in there? Is this it right here?
Yeah, if you land on that platform, it TPs you.
Okay, anyway, so if it's mainly a work in progress, and we're mainly just working on the redstone right now more than anything, because structural and like just details can be worked out later. So
yeah, once I get all the redstone done, I have a whole creative team behind me that's willing to work on this, and they'll hammer out the kinks, make it look beautiful, and it'll be nice. So if you want to see the spawn system, there's just all sorts of buttons here. This says whether or not you can join a game or if there's a game in progress. This resets everything and TPs everybody here. This button over here right behind James is only to be used if you really screw up the map.
And what does it actually do exactly?
Resets absolutely everything. It nullifies all redstone signals, it resets all the basic commands and the scoreboard system. It sets everything up basically. If you were starting this map and it didn't have the scoreboard set up on it or any of the redstone working, if you press that button, it starts it.
Okay.
Now it won't do anything now because everything's already working.
Okay.
But basically, this is the spawn system, and if you go on into any one of these little rooms, go on this platform, it teleports you to the spawn room for that team. And as you can see on the right side of your screen, our names just turn to blue because we are on the blue team. If you click the change teams button, you go back, your name turns to white. And that's pretty much all I'm going to show for this video.
Okay.
Because I want it to be a little bit of a surprise.
Well, what about just the thing that goes to the shop, so...
Yeah.
Since we're...
Oh. You can just TP to the shop.
You teleported me. No, so yeah, this brings us to the shop, so... Yeah.
So. And back to the start. So, thanks for watching, I appreciate it. Any comments, feel free to ask. Like, subscribe, favorite.
And don't forget to subscribe to me, like, favorite. Like me on the Book of the Face, and follow me on the tweets of the twits. Peace out, guys.